Hello everyone, I, Sunil Patel from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Electronics and Communication, welcomes you to the session of wireless communication. Today we are going to discuss about Unit 4, that is Multiple Access Techniques, with topic OFDM. So let's start the session. First of all, as we have already discussed about the separate multiple access techniques in the last session, that is FDMA, TDMA and CDMA, frequency division multiple access, time division multiple access and code division multiple access, we have seen the individual advantages of each system. But for the next, to enhance the better performance of the multiple access technique, one more technique that is introduced in the wireless communication, that is our OFDM system. It stands for Orthogonal Frequency Division Multiplexing. Now, what are the advantages that OFDM offers compared to the other multiplexing techniques? So, that are, first one is narrower bandwidth, because always when we have even talked about the cellular concept or maybe the radio propagation, in all the technique we have seen that there is a very very high amount of bandwidth lost is possible. So here in the OFDM technique we tries to minimize the bandwidth based adjustments so that the system utilization or bandwidth utilization can be more can be made more easy or more utilized. So for that, OFDM will offer us the narrower bandwidth. The next one is also because the bandwidth is narrower, it will offer the efficient usage of power. Utilization is also possible. Now, if there is a narrower bandwidth, then we can say that there is an intermodulation product which will cause signal to interference ratio, that signal to interference ratio, and minimize the intermodulation product of the OFDM. So this elimination of intermodulation product is also possible with this. Here with this figure you can see that there are different components. Here we consider the 6 multicarrier system. So for that we can say that intermodulation can be reduced by using this technique. So here, as you say that 1 to 6 multicarrier bandwidth is available for this, means by using the multicarrier technique we can offer the more and more bandwidth, and approximate bandwidth means total bandwidth is reduced. So that's why it offers the overall narrower bandwidth. The principle of orthogonality is the reason behind it. Orthogonality is related with the correlation of the system. Here, OFDM uses the data bus to reduce the inter-symbol interference. We have seen that intermodulation is reduced. So, how it will be possible with the with OFDM? Because it will use the data bus instead of transmitted single time slot data. That is possible in case of TDMA, that in case of TDMA your data is transmitted in terms of time slots one by one, while in case of FDMA your data is transmitted in terms of frequency band, while in case of OFDM you can see this feature that it will use the data bus, and that's why it will reduce the inter-symbol interference. Now when the symbol duration increases, ISI will always reduce it. So that is the advantage of it. To reduce the multipath effect, if the total symbol duration increases and ISI will reduce, then it will affect on the multipath effect, because the obstacles in between them also gets reduces. And if the obstacles will reduces, we can say that multipath effect will reduce. Okay, to reduce the frequency selective fading, we have already talked about the various type of fading in the unit number 3, that frequency selective fading is there. So in which we have used the Cohen's bandwidth term to relate it with it. If you don't see that lecture of unit number 3, please rewind it so that this thing will be more clear. To reduce the frequency selective fading, fading is related to the rapid fluctuations that will occur in the system. So this should be reduced. Now for the OFDM transmitter and receiver, the block diagram. First block is FEC. FEC is the forward error corrector block. After forward error corrector, interleaving is there. Interleaving will do the random conversion of the random errors into the burst form. Now, if once the error is converted into the burst form, inverse Fourier transformation is done. This IFT stands for inverse Fourier transformation to get the original signal. And then by getting the original signal, we will introduce some guard interval so that overlapping will be reduced. So here that is the concept of guard interval is also there to reduce the overlapping of the system. Then it will be given to the symbol shaping. And then again in phase modulator, modulation will be done for that on that signal, and then it will be transmitted. So here you can see the difference that before going to the modulator, there are some blocks of interleaver and guard interval to reduce the errors occurred in the system. After that, the mixture will gives you the combined gain. TGC is there, your TGC block is also there, and then it will be transmitted by the antenna. So this is all about the OFDM transmitter. If you talk about if you want to draw the block diagram for the receiver, it will be completely in a reverse order. Hearing in case of in phase modulator, you have to use it the demodulator over there. Then in case of inverse Fourier transfer, you should use the Fourier transformation, and in case of the interleaving mapping, you should use the deinterleaving over that. And in place of coder, there is a decoder. So here data stream is sent in form of symbol. Quadration modulation is that each symbol is assigned to the one of the subcarrier. Okay. Now every symbol frame is transformed to the IFFT, means inverse fast Fourier transformation. So these are some list of the points that will be used for the OFDM transmitter and receiver. So it is sensitive to the phase as well as frequency noise. Means if there is some phase or frequency noise is there, we should use the guard interval to reduce that particular case. In short, to minimize the correct pulse shape, it needs to be selected for that. Next one is about CSMA. CSMA stands for carrier sense multiple access technique. Here each terminal on network is able to monitor the status before transmission, means whether it get acknowledged or not, that is also matter. So here the detection delay will introduced in the system, means whether the particular bit is transmitted after some delay or not, or if the delay is there, then what then in which amount that delay is introduced. So all these things will be taken care of in case of CSMA. Propagation delay is also that. Also here, if someone wants to find out the time period for the propagation delay, then it will be given by TD into TP. TD is equal to, means delay time is equal to TP, that is propagation time, into RD is your bit rate, divided by the factor M, where M is your expected number of bits in the data packets. Types of CSMA is one persistent CSMA. Here the terminal will transmit the message with the probability 1. Probability 1 with probability 1 it will transmit, so that's why it is called as one persistent CSMA. Non-persistent means it will wait for some random time interval, not for the particular fixed time interval like for the 5 seconds or 6 seconds, but it will wait for a random time interval, and if in that random time interval the acknowledgement will not get from the receiver side, so it will again retransmit that particular bit. So this is all about the non-persistent CSMA. Next one is P persistent. So in this case, some of the bits is transmitted with the P probability. So packet is transmitted with first available slot with P probability, and then the rest of the packets will be transmitted with the probability of 1 minus P. Next one is about CSMA CD. CSMS series stands for Carrier-Sense Multiple Access Collision Detect. So here, user monitors the transmission of the collision, means whenever it will occur, this particular CSMA will activate. It means, in short, it will occur only at the time of collision. There is also another method, that is collision avoidance. So CSMA-CA is there for that purpose. So as we discussed, there are several access methods are there. Also, the case of hidden terminal and exposed terminal is also there. Here, this is the case of the hidden terminal. For example, if the user A, B, C, and D is there, and here the particular node, for example, if A is transmitted to C terminal, and in that case, the terminal D is hidden for terminal A. And same way, if D is transmitted the data to the B, so in for the D, terminal A will become the hidden terminal. Same way for the exposed terminal also, same figure we have taken. So for the exposed terminal, if we took the case of A to C transmission, then in that case for C and for A, B is the exposed terminal, and same way for if we talk about this second circle, then for that terminal C is exposed to terminal D. So this is about the terminal that is hidden or exposed for the access methods. So this is all about the OFDM and access terminals. If you find any query regarding the session, you can ask me on my email ID.